Good morning. Today we'll discuss about the geometric rectification. We know whatever the in remote sensing and GIS, whatever the data we are going to process, before that rectification is required, because without rectification we cannot go for the next process, because rectification is a process where the geometry of an image is made to be planimetric. Geometry of an image is made to be planimetric. This is also known as the georeferencing. Or simply rectification. So the most common geometric correction measures, usually the image to map rectification, and image to image rectification. These are the two types of rectification processes are generally considered in for the geometric correction of the satellite data and the different types of maps. So these two elementary procedures are accomplished in the geometric rectification. One is known as the spatial interpolation. Second one is the intensity interpolation. Right? So in spatial interpolation, we have account the picture location into the real world features. And intensity, there is a change of pixel values, that is the digital number values of the pixel, to represent its actual or appropriate position. So now coming to the spatial interpolation. The Feynman method of the geometric correction, that is comprises of the spatial interpolation, where the input and the output image coordinate will be calculated. To calculate this image coordinate, suppose this is the x pixel, right? So this x pixel, that can be calculated as f1 into x, y and f2 into x and y. So this x and y is the distorted input image coordinate. And this x and y equal to, this is the, and this x and y is the corrected image coordinate. And f1 is the transformation function. Transformation function. So this image coordinate has been calculated with the help of polynomial transformation function. In general, we are using this polynomial transform, which is used for the Raworth setting, based on Raworth setting, polynomial transformation function. I will discuss it later in the next class, what is the polynomial transformation function. That is using the generally Raworth setting technique. Raworth setting technique. So this polynomial transformation function, what is happening, that like it causes the translation change of scale, skew and rotation of the XY coordinate. In this polynomial transformation, this is causes the translation, scale change, skew and rotation of the XY coordinate. So here, for example, if we consider this first polynomial, it can be represented in the first order, second order, third order, or more. So suppose, for example, the first order polynomial transformation can be represented as, suppose x equal to a0 plus a1x plus a2y. And y equal to v0, b1, x and b2, y. So here, a and v are the estimated ground control point values. Estimated ground control point values. For example, I will give an example of how to rectify an image. Suppose this is a point, these are the four points that is having the GCP values. Suppose it will be rectified by estimated GCP. So the rectified image look like that. After using this polynomial transformation function and the coefficient value in the special interpolation technique. Next is the intensity interpolation. In this intensity interpolation, that constant contains the abstraction of the digital number values from the input image to trace it in the output image to its appropriate position. And it is also known as the resampling. Right? And this method, account the location of the output pixel to its conforming location, the input pixel. It is the location of output pixel. Location of output pixel creates conforming location of input pixel. There are three types of interpolation, intensity interpolation are used. First is the nearest neighbor. Bilinear and cubic. So these three interpolation technique or resampling method are used in this intensity interpolation to change the DN values of the input pixel and its environment to its exact location of the output pixel of the rectified image. Now the nearest neighbor intensity interpolation. Here the gray value of the image pixel is assigned to the nearest base map coordinates. Like this is the pixel location. Suppose pixel is missing in this point, in this point, in this point. So it can take the values from here, either from here or here, or the average value may be calculated for this pixel. So this is called nearest neighbor. The advantage of this technique, very fastest and cheapest method of resampling, and does the least radiometric damage of the data. And there are also disadvantages of this. Like, what are the advantages? One is the radiometric accuracy of the data will be maintained. And disadvantage is that it can create the blocky image. Next, coming to the bilinear. In bilinear interpolation, it calculates the weighted mean of 4 pixels. Calculated the weighted mean of 4 pixels of the raw input image. For example, this is the pixel location. Suppose this pixel information is missing, so it calculate the value from this 4 pixel of this particular location to from the raw input image. So it can be represented as like summation 4 k equal to 1 z k by d 2 k divided by summation 4 k equal to 1 by d 2 k. This interpolation having an advantage like image resulting from the resampling will be smoother. Less blocky appearance. And the less effect on the value assigned to the coordinate. Next, last one is the QV interpolation. QV interpolation. Here the weighted value calculated. Of 16 nearest pixel. That is VV brightness value of the void equal to 16 k equal to 1 z k divided by d k 16 k equal to 1 by d 2 k. So z actually z is the surrounding of point data values. Surrounding of point data values or pixel data values, and d are the distance in squared, distance in squared of the x and y location, x and y location. So here the measuring the distance from the 16 pixel and these are the surrounding data points. So in this way that cubic interpolation technique is used to calculate it, the DN values in the rectified image from the input raw image data. What are the advantages? These are more intensive original histogram approach. Original histogram approach produces the visible results of the original input image. So this type of rectification, the spatial and intensity interpolation, is used in the rectification process of the raw image data to get an rectified output image using the coordinate response to represent its x correct location of x and y position, and also changing the brightness value of the pixel in its appropriate position. Thank you for watching this video.